You must have worked a lot with validations in Excel and just thought how great it would be to have dependent data validations. Well, let's today tackle this problem and see how we can easily put dependent validations in our Excel cells. Now, before that, let's just try to see how does validation work in Excel. So let's just try and go to this particular sheet here. Okay, now here we have a database in which we want to enter the name, the age and the city, and we want the city to be from this particular list. Now we know that every time if you have a person, a data operator who is entering the names of the cities here, there's every chance that he'll make a typo, and the next time when you make a pivot table or you're doing some calculations, there's every possibility that because of the typo, the list is not proper. So what we'll do is that in this particular cell here, we'll put a validation, and in that validation we'll just select this list. So what we'll do is that we'll just select the first cell, go to data, validations, and here you can see that there are various types of options available. You have a whole number, decimal, list, date, time, text, length and custom. So in this case, let's just select a list over here. You'll see that the source option opens up, and here you click over here and then just select the entire list till here and then press OK. Now once you edit the validation, you can see that you get a small drop down at the corner of this cell, and once you click it, you can see that this entire list shows up here. You can select any one out of this list and it will be referring to the particular list here, so there's no chance of a typo. And in fact, if you try to add anything else over here, it will just throw an error. Let's say I put down Glasgow. So yeah, it will actually throw an error over here. Now you can just copy this particular cell and paste it on the entire series, and your validation is also copied in those particular cells. Now let's try another validation. Let's say you want the age of the person to be selected between 18 and 40. So you just go over here, select one cell, go to data, validations, and earlier we had selected a list, now we'll select a whole number. So it will give a minimum and the maximum number. Let's say the minimum is 18 and the maximum is 40. Click OK. And now if I try to kind of put any other number or any other age apart from these numbers, let's say I put 12, it should throw me an error. I put 45. Again, throw me an error. And let's say I put down 38, so it will select it. I'll just copy this cell and paste it in the entire database. So this is how the entire validation thing works. And let's now go to see what are dependent data validations. So in order to understand dependent data validations, let us look at this particular database. Let's say I have this database which has got the different countries and the cities in them. Now let's say I got this form, and in this form I want that against every preferred country I enter the country, and every time I enter this country I should get the list from this particular database. Let's say I selected USA. In the validations I should get only the cities of USA. In Canada I should get the cities of Canada, and so on. So there are actually two ways to do it. One is a very crude way and the other one is a very sophisticated and easy way. So let's look at the first option to work on those validations. So let's say this is a form, and in the preferred country what we'll do is that we'll use data, validation, and then we'll select list, and in the source we'll just go back to the database and select all the countries here and press OK. Now if you see here, you got a small drop down and you have all the countries here. Now let me just select one particular country here. Let's say I selected China, and now I'll put down the validation here. So what I'll do is that I'll just make a small table here, and let me just equal to this particular cell to the preferred country. Now I'll go back to the database and see what is the maximum number of cities that I have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it is 8 cities is the maximum. So I'll
just make a table of 8 cities here by just equaling it to the first cell. Now if I have to look at this database, this is the second row of the database, so it'll go 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So I'll just put down the number, row number of, not the actual row number as per the Excel sheet, but the row number as per the table over here. So it'll be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Now I'll use a simple H lookup formula, which is equal to H lookup of this cell, comma. Then I'll go to the database, select this entire array, comma, and then I'll go to the form and select this particular cell, which actually refers to the row number, comma, 0 for false. Bracket close, enter. Now first of all, freeze the coordinates of the table by putting a dollar sign before B2 and E10. So we have a dollar here, 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 and here. Okay. Now even if you copy this formula to all the below cells, the formula will not change, the table position will not change. So just copy it and paste it till here. So this is what you get. And of course, I'm sorry, I had actually missed one cell because it has got 8 rows. So we'll need to put down the number 9 as well, equal to this, and then copy it here and paste it. Now you'll also notice that it has got these additional zeros. You want to remove it and have a blank over here. So we will put an if formula. So for that, what you need to do is just copy or cut this formula and put if the logical test is this thing is equal to 0, then you put down double quotes, comma, and then the formula again, brackets close, enter. And then you just copy it and paste it in the other cells as well. See, now those zeros are gone and you have blanks over here. Now notice that every time you change the country over here, the cities over here will also change. Let's say I selected USA, I get all the cities of USA. I change it to Canada, I get the cities of Canada. So now you have a list over here which is ready for you. And the simplest thing to do is you go to preferred city, E15, go to data, validations, put down a list, and the source over here, you just select this particular data which I have highlighted in yellow, and then press OK. Now see, here the preferred country is Canada, and the preferred cities list will have all the required options. Similarly, if you select USA, you'll get the list of cities from USA. Now let's look at the second option, which is the simplest and the easiest. And it of course incorporates lists and named lists. By the way, most of us who work on Excel regularly, I don't understand why we don't use these lists. These are very useful and you can see it from this example. Now what we'll do is that we'll go to our database and select the countries first. Let's select all the countries here. And here where the name appears, or currently it's showing B2, let's name this list. Let's call it List 1. Enter. So now when you select it again, it will not show you B2. It'll show you List 1. Right. Now what we'll do is that the second option is to actually go over here, select this entire array, go to Insert, Name, and then you do a create. Make sure that only top row is selected over here. You remove the left column and click OK. It'll ask you to replace existing definition of USA and all the other countries. Just keep clicking yes on them. Right. So now what we have done is that we have created two lists, two named lists in fact. One is for the countries and the other one is for the cities in them. Now what I'll do is that I'll go back to my form here, and in the preferred country, I'll first of all put a simple data validation, which is data validation. And when I select the list,
I put down equal to, and if you remember, I had named that particular list of countries as list one. So I'll just put it verbatim over here, equal to list1, list one, and press OK. Now, if you go over here and check this drop down, it will show you all the countries that are in list one. Great. Now we have to select the preferred city. For that, we'll use the validation again, and in validation, we'll use a formula this time, and that formula would be indirect. What indirect formula does is that it will refer to the preferred country, and from there, it will select the values of those particular cities that exist in that country. Let's try it out. So we have selected this particular cell. We'll go to data, validation, list, and we'll do equal to indirect bracket start. I'll refer to the preferred country cell, bracket close, and then press OK. It'll show me a warning because I have not selected anything in the preferred country, which is OK. I'll press yes, and we are done. Now let's try and test this formula and test this validation. So let me select countries here. USA over here. I go over here. A small drop down has already appeared here, and let's see the magic. All the cities that we had kind of listed in the database are showing it here. Let's change the country now, and of course it does show me these cities as well. So friends, here it is. You can see how easy the work becomes by using named lists. So try to use them as much as you can, and you'll see it helps a lot. Write down in the comment section if you have any queries, and don't forget to like and share this video.